Right, so he got some treats, some pets, and we're gonna turn right around and try again, see how he does. Come on, let's go.
Most donkeys, each time you do it, it gets a little bit easier, a little bit less scary. I've only had one donkey where that was not the case, and that was Skillet. I think that was because there was some vision issues going on. But most of them, once they get used to it, they're like, oh, this isn't so bad. Step up.
Good boy.
Good boy. And I still do lots of treats because he's still learning.
Good. Good boy.
Good boy. Good job. So he gets those 2 feet in, he gets lots of treats. Good. And we're going to keep walking forward, see if he'll come the rest of the way. And if he wants to step out, I'm going to let him. That's totally fine. Let's try again. It's okay. Learns that he's not trapped in there. Good. And so he doesn't get a treat for that one, but he did get treats while his feet were in the trailer. So we're going to ask him again. Come on. Oh, and this is kind of just frustration. Come on. Nope. Hey, 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 hey. Come touch. You can do it. Here we go, boy. Come on. I know you can do it. Nope, we're not gonna eat grass. No. Come touch, please. Good boy. There you go. Touch. Good job, bud. Come on, buddy. Got a four-wheeler out in the field behind us, so they do get used to a lot here. One thing I can say for it. Good boy. There you go. Good boy. Oh, you scared yourself. Did you scare yourself? That was silly. That was silly. Again, I'm not trying to pull him in the trailer, I'm just holding pressure.
Good. 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 Good.
Good boy.
Good boy.
You can see donkeys are very expressive with their tails when they're frustrated.
Good.
And this is definitely more pressure and release, where I'm putting a little bit of pressure on him and then take it off when he's facing the trailer or stepping into the trailer. There are treats, but it's not positive reinforcement. But I feel like it's important to do both because these guys need to learn how to cope under pressure. Some of the pure positive training is like they're never under pressure, and then when you do have to put pressure on them, whether it's an emergency or whatever, they just lose their minds. So this way they learn how to accept pressure and give into it. But I definitely also use a lot of positive reinforcement techniques. Come on. No. 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 Come on. No. 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 No.
boy. Good boy. Here we go.
So I do this just to save my back. So I loop it through the tie thing there, and he's in kicking.
Mad? Are you mad? You don't need to be mad. Come on, let's go. Let's go. You're all right. Come on.
Again, I'm not trying to pull him in. Just have some pressure on him. Good boy! Good job, bud! Nice work! Good boy! Treats. Hold him in. Come on, buddy. No. Get mad at him when they react like that. He's just expressing frustration and displeasure. So like I said, we'll ask for just his front feet and then we'll be done for today. Come on. Good boy. Good job. Good boy. So he gets treats, and then we're going to be done for today. No use turning into a battle. We've got plenty of time. Good boy. Oh, good. Just going to step on out. Come on, too. He wants to. Good boy. Good job.